John Federico here with On Digital Media. Joining me at the Spreecast booth is Colin Evans, who's with Spreecast. I don't know exactly what Colin does, but I heard he's good with sound bites. So we're going to talk with Colin about Spreecast and what it actually does. Welcome, Colin.
Thank you very much.
So tell our audience what Spreecast is. Now, I know what it is. I knew what it was as soon as I saw it, and I was all excited. But obviously, I want to hear it coming from you.
It is a social video platform that lets people broadcast together. You can have up to 4 people actively participating in the video player, and they can be talking to an audience that is, in essence, limitless. It could be 100 people. It can be 1,000 people. Unlike the platforms that are out there, the audience can actually interact with the people on camera, and they can do so in 3 ways. They can chat in real time with anybody else in the viewing audience. They can actually submit questions that can be approved and dragged onto the screen by the person who's controlling the Spreecast, or they can actually request to join on camera and come on camera with the people that are hosting the Spreecast.
That's great. So that means that anyone who happens to be in the audience, if they want to jump on and participate in the discussion and be on screen to be broadcast to the rest of the audience, they can do that?
They can request to do that. The people who set up the Spreecast are what we call the hosts. The hosts have producer controls. Those producer controls let the hosts identify people that want to come on camera, screen their video to make sure it's working before they pull them on camera, look at questions that people have submitted from the viewing audience, and approve or reject the questions that they want to involve in the broadcast. So as a producer or the host of the Spreecast, you actually have significant control over what's happening on camera, who's on camera, how long they're on camera, what questions you're answering or involving in the Spreecast itself. All that can be controlled by the producer.
So you use a lot of common terms here, like producer and host. Sounds like television. So who's your target audience for this product primarily? I'm going to guess it's media makers like me.
It's really an open platform. So we are building an open video platform that lets any type of content creator create their own shows. It can be a person who's showing how to cook their favorite recipe. It can be a sommelier who's reviewing their favorite wine. It can be 2 co-hosts of a particular show that may be talking about sports or politics or current events. And it can be an interview format where it can be just like what we're doing here, but done online, where one person can be at home behind their computer and another person can be on the other side of the country behind their computer, and all that's needed for Spreecast is a browser and internet connection.
And I'm guessing that it uses Flash.
It does use Flash.
I forgot to put the mic there. It does use Flash.
It does use Flash.
Okay, good. And it looks like you can have up to 4 participants at a time. Any thoughts on expanding that or any other, tweaks that we'll see to the platform soon?
The 4 people on camera is our decision. It's not limited by technology. We believe that in order to foster a productive dialogue, having 4 people on camera is actually the best number of people before that starts to erode. If you look at some of the people that are out there, they may have 10 people or 12 people on camera at once. I think that's much more conducive to a bunch of people that know each other hanging out and talking, as opposed to what we're building, which is a broadcast platform where 4 people can actively be talking. It can go down to 1 person. It can then stay at 2 people. It doesn't need to be 4 at all times. And that can be broadcast out to a much larger audience.
Sure. And I actually happen to agree with you. It just so happens that for our regular listeners know that our show is typically panel style. And we have, it's myself and 3 co-panelists. And so something like this works great for us. But occasionally we do get the 5th or 6th, in which case, I guess, we're out of luck in that regard.
Necessarily. What we have here is the ability to involve 4 at one time. But say I was doing a show where there were 2 judges or 3 judges and a bunch of contestants. I could cycle 50 people through that final square or quarter of the screen, and at the end of the Spreecast actually have involved 55 different people. It's only 4 people on camera at one particular time. So in your case, you could actually have 4 people that were actively talking, and then when the 5th person wanted to come in, you'd replace them you'd replace somebody on the screen with the new person that you wanted to involve.
Okay, well, there you go. You just fixed my use case, my issue to my use case. So is it available right now?
It is available right now. We're in beta. We've only been live for a few short weeks. We are coming out of beta towards the end of next week. At this point, you have to have an invitation to be able to create Spreecast. That is going to be removed next Thursday, November 10th, and then anybody will be able to create a Spreecast.
So I would imagine I would get an invitation, right, Colin?
Yep, you can get an invitation. Right?
Okay, that's great. I love it.
Send it to you.
That'd be great. And so let's see, we're recording this at Blog World Expo, by the way, which I forgot to mention. We're talking, what is today, November 4th?
November 4th.
So we should expect to have this in public. public beta, what, November 10th. Okay, that's great. Thank you, Colin. So again, it's Colin Evans from Spreecast, and this is On Digital Media at Blog World Expo, Los Angeles, 2011.